to everyone.
Hi, my name is Reverend Valerie Pearson. I'm the Executive Director for the Center for Remarkable Women, and I have company today. I am joined today by three of my friends, three remarkable women. Lauren Preston is here, Angel Murrill is here, and Minister Anna Brown is here with me today. And we're going to talk about the journey, the remarkable woman journey. We have a new season that's upcoming, the season of restoration for the class of 2016. But I want you to hear from some women that have already taken the journey and from a couple of women that are still taking the journey but are very close to the end of this particular journey. So they're going to tell you about the journey, and I hope that you are encouraged to take this awesome journey as well. Lauren, I'm going to start with you. Tell me why you took the journey first.
Well, I retired for the past 2 years, and I was embarking on my 60th birthday, and I said, I've done a lot for my job, my family, and what was I going to do for myself? So I decided that I would look into coming to the Remarkable Woman organization. And a friend of mine went through it last year, and she just raved about it. So I said, it's time for me to invest in myself. And that's when I decided to come and visit. I cried my way through the first visit, but it was a good cry. It was a cry that let me know that this is a place where I could develop, I could unfold and become the person that I want to be, that I know is deep down inside of me.
So why would you encourage another woman to take this journey?
Because it's a safe environment. And quite often for women, we tend to feel uncomfortable exposing ourselves to others, especially to other women. But it's a safe environment. It's a caring environment. It's a God-filled environment. And I think that that's the most important thing, that I feel God's presence whenever I come into this place. And it's important, I think, for all of us to feel that presence as we develop and we grow.
Thank you. Ms. Angel, tell me why you decided to take this journey first.
I decided to take this journey because I saw a friend of mine go through it, and she was not the same. And also because I knew at this point in my life, if I didn't do something, I would never come out of my shell or even learn who I really am. And I was definitely nervous at first, but I said, okay, God, I'll pray about it, I'll think about it. But when I came to the meeting, I felt His presence, and I knew it'd be a big mistake if I did not take it. So I felt led to
it. Now tell me why another woman. There's a woman watching out there. Tell her why she should take this journey.
I recommend any and all women to take it, because the change that you experience is one that is amazing. It's joy, it's some sadness, it's some self-recognition, but through it all you have so many women like yourself and Lauren as well to just help pull you through it. And I always go back to Moses lately, because Moses said, let my people go so they can praise Him in the wilderness. And for me, learning how to praise God through it all, but sticking through something and understanding who I am and what He has designed me to be, I recommend women to take it for that purpose.
Awesome. Thank you. Minister Brown, you're from the class of 2013. Now, these ladies are still taking the journey, still on the journey, but you've completed the journey. So tell us, first of all, why you decided to take the journey way back, and that would be in 2012 when you decided.
Absolutely. Well, I saw your Remarkable Woman journal. It was a young lady that I knew. I knew a little bit about her life and what was going on in it. And in the journal, she had a smile from ear to ear. And I said to my family members, whatever it is that has changed her, that has transformed her, I wanted the same. And so I came to the meetings, enjoyed what I heard, and I decided it's time to restore the joy back into my life. I came, enjoyed women, gained plenty of sisters, plenty of friends, and it was truly transformative for all of us. It's also where I answered my call. So I became a woman of purpose. I was always a woman of purpose as a mother, as a wife, you know, even in the working world, in my community, but a woman of a different purpose now. So I found my purpose while I was here. So I would encourage everyone, come, restore your joy, restore your health, restore your happiness, restore your wealth. Find your wealth, find your purpose.
Thank you, that was great. I hope that you have heard something that has touched your heart, and you will decide too that you want to be a part of the center. You want to be a part of the remarkable woman journey, that you want to be all that you were created to be. These women had awesome journeys, and I know that you will have an awesome journey as well. I want to invite you to come to our next open house, which will be Wednesday, June the 17th, starting at 6 o'clock. You can come here to the center. You'll be able to talk to women who have taken the journey. You'll be able to talk to facilitators, to our life coach, Elaine Scales, and also another open house on Saturday, July 11th. Which will start at 9 a.m. So we invite you, don't let this season of restoration pass you by. God has restoration in store for you. Thank you, ladies. Thank you so very much. God bless you.